My name is Jill. Thank you for joining me for another workout. Today I have a muscle class designed with a bit of mobility because not only are we strengthening and building some muscular endurance, but we also need to take care of the tendons, the ligaments, all the little cables that are wrapped around the joints. So we're going to start with a warm-up here. This is a great class if you're not looking for high impact on the joints and you really want a good muscle burn. It also helps to stoke that metabolism. When you're building up the muscles in your legs, the glutes, those are your larger assets, and it also helps to stimulate the HGH, which are muscle growth hormones, and that will simply stimulate muscle growth in the entire body. So I just recommend you stay hydrated, listen to your body, and I will offer you modifications. I will also be incorporating a few tidbits of little pieces of equipment that you might find around the house, but I will be giving you those options without those pieces of equipment. So join me when you're ready. I'll get the music started. One slight variation in today's workout is the music will be different. There will be gaps in between tracks. So you want to treat this workout as if you're just going to the gym and you've got your headphones on and you're not really going to the beat of the music. That's the execution today. So I'll get started. Light set of weights just for the warm up here. Getting ourselves mentally, physically prepared for the workout. Roll the shoulders, feet at least hip width distance apart. Tummy in nice and tight. You want to pull the ribs down. Spine is aligned and neutral. We're going to squat down nice and slow. And up. Exhale. Inhale. Chest facing me. Keep those joints soft in the knees and the hips. Down. Nice and slow. Up. Your movement always follows your breath. Keep breathing here. A little quicker. Down. And up. We're activating the glutes on the way up. Good. Now that you've got the form, a little quicker. Good. Pulse three. Again. Three, two, one. Hold that pulse pattern. Legs are warming up here. We're going to go for singles. We have eight. Good job. Four more, three, deadlift, step together, down, up, flat spine, side view, hips are neutral at the top, squeeze your glutes, boom, four more, down, up, open the chest, shoulders down. Biceps coming up, warming up the elbows, getting the blood into the upper body, up and down. So the elbows are in nice and tight. Activate the rhomboids, squeeze your shoulder blades together. A little quicker. Squeeze it up. Four more. Three, side lateral raise, slow it down. Hold on, hold on. Out. And down. Palms facing the floor on
pinkies back, thumbs forward, singles. Last two. Let's put those weights down. Grab a sip of water if you need. So we're gonna start with legs here. So I'm going to use a resistance band that's going to help to activate the glutes, bring more awareness to the activation that's supporting the hips. These waistbands, leg bands, resistance bands, always optional. Also helps to bring more awareness to the alignment of my knees. So feet at least hip width distance when you're ready. Back to that squat, down, up, chest proud, knees are not buckling in, more activation for the glutes, down, up, great job, down. A little quicker, down, up, nice, more activation coming from my glutes with that resistance band, four more, down, we're going to do some isometric holds, breaking up that momentum, increasing that challenge, watch for the change. Hold the bottom. A little half lift. Bottom. And all the way up. Again. Hold. Bottom. Top. Two more. Half. Bottom. Tall. One more. Stop and go. We're going to speed that up. Same template. And up. Keep going. We're going to go for some singles here. Down and up. Seven. Six. Five. Four. Three. You're going to go another eight. Hold that pattern. We have eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one. Again, we're not going with the beat. It's about that explosive movement towards the top, as fast as you can go. I'd rather you start with no weights at all. feet on. You want to square the hips. Lots of load coming from the front leg. Keep going. Don't worry, we'll shake it out. Nice job. Step it up. Start really slow here. And hold. In four, in three, we're going down slow, up quick. You're just starting out, keep both feet on the floor. Lots of stability. You want to get that back knee nice and low. The lower you go, the harder it gets, guys. Hold on. Four more. Three. Two. Last one. Shake it out. So you can grab a stable surface such as a chair. Very similar to the fire hydrant when you're on all fours, only we're doing this standing. So we're going to go forward first, knee curls. Nice and slow to start. Lots of glutes, hips, glute knee. You're drawing a circle with your knee. Side view. Through. Really feel that in the glutes. So going backwards this time. If you need a break, take it. Steady motion. You can shake it out. Shake it out, you can walk it out. All right, so if you've got a kettlebell, if you've got a looped band, we're just doing knee raises. You don't need the equipment, you can just go up and down with nothing, just giving you options here. You're just starting out. You can hold on to a stable surface. Again, you don't need any weights at all. You can put your arms out for balance. This can sure shine a light on some weaknesses. I've got 5 pounds here. It is tough. Keep going. Last two. Last one. Shake it out. I have a little rubber band just so it doesn't slip off. Square the hips, so your pelvis each side equal distance from the floor. Done. It takes a lot of glutes, a lot of core, a lot of awareness in your body. Last two. Last one. All right, shake it out again.
not sure why my music is stopping in between, so thanks for your patience. Slow it down. Working the inner thighs, piriformis, glutes, legs. Good. Wiggle the toes. Knees stacking your ankles. Get ready. We're going to speed it up. Let's go halfway down. Hold the pulse. Again, you can rest your arms on your thighs, the weights. It's up to you. No weights at all, that's fine. Keep going. Keep going. You're stronger than you think, right to the end. One more. In three. Are you ready? Let's flush it out. Without locking the knees. Good. Pulse again. Keep going, keep going, keep going. Hold this pattern. We're almost there. That spine is nice and tall. Tailbone is pointing down. That tummy is tucked in. Let's flush it out. Up, down. One more. Keep breathing. Last two. All right. Let's stretch it out. Take a wide squat. Slide the hips side to side. Let's go for the biceps. We're not going to spend too much time on the arms. Four more.
Nice job. Shake it out. Reset the upper body. Pulse it out. The key here, keep the upper arms hugging those ribs so you can isolate here. Keep going. Keep going. Get ready for singles. Option to alternate the knees. Relax the foot here. Four more. Going back to the pulses one last time. Arms only. Pulse it out. Pulse it out. Keep going. Keep going. Six, five, four, three, two, singles. Up. If you want to add the knees, like this. Keep going. Hup. Four, three, two, and one. Weights down. Stretch it out. Keep going. Two presses, two arms. Left, right. Lots of core keeping stable on an unstable surface. My feet are not touching the floor. Building that upper body strength, you can lighten up that grip. Keep the blood into the shoulders. As soon as you grasp that weight tightly, release the nutrients in the shoulders. Blood starts to go up into the fingers. One more. Up. Standing, no problem. Weight down. Stretch it out. I don't know what's going on with my music today, but we'll just make it happen. Trying out a new site. All new things, there's a learning curve. Step two, you can lighten the load this time. If it wasn't challenging, go heavier. And start with the right, building that upper body. Let's go.
Try for two more. This is getting tough. I went heavier. Two presses. Use that form without arching the back. I can only do one press. That's tough. I'll feel it tomorrow. Stretch it out. I'm doing one more set. This time I will go lighter. Shake it out. Other arm stretch. You decide what weight you want to use. Two presses. Keep going. Two presses. Weight's in your peripheral vision. Two more. Out, down. If you don't have any weights, you don't have any resistance, lengthen those levers, relying on gravity, body weight, or resistance. Keep going. Try without the resistance bands, same load, out, down, keep
try the top half. It's a huge difference. We're not letting off any breaks there. Keep going. Four. Three. Two. One. Great job, guys. I feel like I'm just at the gym doing my own workout, only sharing it. Nothing super coordinated or choreographed. Shake it out. Other side. We're gonna go anterior raise and upright row. It's a smaller muscle group from right here. Slow. Draw the shoulders away from your ears. Keep going. Upright row, again back to the medial delts and anterior. Keep the weights in close to your body like you're zipping up a winter jacket. You can also modification one arm at a time. You want to keep your movements smooth and steady. Keep going. Higher than that collarbone. My shoulders are already burning from the previous exercises. We're only doing four more. Then we're moving into back. Last one. Weights down. And same stretch for the shoulders, or you can bring your arm behind. Ear to shoulder while I turn on that music again. One knee on the step, you have a table, you can do it on the floor. Speed it up. Keep going. two and 12. Other side. Make sure your surface is stable. Feed it up. Tricep, and without arching the back, keep it going. Stretch it out. I'm going to do the tricep dip. You can do a tricep kickback. If you're doing the tricep dip, again, keep your elbows in line with your shoulders, fingers forward. Down. You should never be sharp pain in your shoulder. If there is, go back to the overhead tricep extension. Don't underestimate those triceps and your body weight. Keep the hips close to the steps. If you want the added challenge, kick out your feet. This is enough for me. I'm going to speed it up. Singles, then I'm going to pulse. It's more progressive, it's a faster way to burn out those triceps. If you want a less load, bring your feet in a little closer. It lightens up that body weight. Three, in two, speed it up. I'm going to blast out those triceps. Keep going. Keep going. Eight. And four. Three. Two. One. Lower the camera. We've got our glutes.
Grab a match.
Down to your mat and hold.
For more advanced, we're going to kick one foot out, keep the hips square, and we'll dip. Modification, keep both feet on the floor. Down into the floor. Four, three, two, one. Hug your knees in. The glute that was working, cross that leg over the opposite knee and hug it in. Rock your hips side to side, going back in for the other round. Other leg, anchor the shoulders down, lift up the hips. Look down, see how your hips are square, equal distance to the floor. No arch in the low back, it's all about the glutes. When you're ready, other leg comes out. Now if that toe is pointing out, that means your hips are slanted. Toe should point directly to the ceiling and dip. A neutral back and go part way. It's all about the glutes. Make that mind-body connection. Knees in. Nice. And cross. Those glutes are just as important as the quads. A lot of times when we squat, we're quad dominant. Finish off with rows and plank. So we're hitting the back one last time. Again, if you don't have weights, you can go regular plank. Try to prevent the hips from swaying side to side. Four, three, two, one. Come down. Stretching it out. Chin to chest, hold that. Rounding up the spine. And hold. Set it up. We're almost there. Almost there. Stretch it out. our angle here for plank. So first we start in high plank. Gonna target some obliques here. When you're ready, right knee, right shoulder. Child's pose.
in the back. Switch. Hips come into high plank. You can do this from the knee again, up to you. Bring your chest toward the front knee. Open it up again, another twist in your spine, and hold. In between, inside the front foot, you can open up the knee here. Back knee, bring your hips back and hold for a hamstring. Let's switch it over to the other side. Step forward, opening the hips. Reduce the tension that builds up in the workout. Never bring sharp pain, so ease off. Right foot, widen out the leg, and we'll stretch there for the hips. Down, take the hips back. Toe to chest, more length in the back of your legs. So I'm not counting, but I'm pretty sure there are about 50 videos in the vault. So today's workout was trying something new. As you know, the space, the lighting, the music, everything is trial and error in Jilco Bodywork Studio. Thank you for your patience. If you have any feedback, please private message or drop a comment. But all of the comments add credibility to the workout platform, this channel. So I do appreciate the comments. It helps to keep everybody motivated, including myself. Please like, subscribe, share at Jilco Bodywork's Facebook and YouTube. Have a great night, everyone.